The title of our video must surely have intrigued you enough to make you click on our link, so that you ended up here on our channel. You must also have heard of the question a number of times. Also, if soda can actually melt your bones and teeth, carbonated beverages, such as sodas or soft drinks, contain a lot of sugar and calories. This makes them a major contributor to obesity, diabetes, and tooth decay. But can they really melt your bones or cause hip fracture? One theory that has been proposed to support this assertion is that carbonated drinks contain phosphate to enhance their flavor. This phosphoric acid is said to disrupt the body's absorption of calcium, causing the bones to lose this mineral. Subsequent studies, however, have shown that this is not really the case. Even high amounts of phosphate have not been established to affect bone density or bone metabolism. Nevertheless, a 2006 study published by the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition revealed that women who drank sodas had a lower bone mineral density, or BMD, compared to those who didn't. The male subjects, on the other hand, had no such result. In 2014, the journal did another study, which showed that hip fracture is more prevalent in women who drank more than 10 sodas per week. The research involved 73,000 women aged 30 to 55 years monitored for 30 years. So why does soda cause hip fracture? We'll give the answer in a minute. But first, please don't forget to like this video if you find it interesting. Also, make sure you subscribe to this channel so you can get your daily dose of fun and informative videos. Now, on to our concern. Scientists have long thought that it's the caffeine in the soda that is causing the high rate of broken bones and fractures among soda drinkers. They suspected it's due to its interaction with the phosphorus and the carbonation in the soda. Unfortunately, there is still no definite verdict on the matter. More recent studies have debunked this notion on caffeine. While it is true that the substance has some direct effect on calcium, it is so minimal that it's actually negligible. This was proven by a randomized study published by the Creighton University Osteoporosis Research Center in 2001. 32 people were made to drink different kinds of soda for a month. Urine samples were regularly taken to see how much calcium was being expelled by the body as a direct result of soda intake. Those who drank sodas did excrete calcium, while the subjects who did not have any soda did not lose calcium in their urine. However, the level of calcium loss was determined to be insignificant to have an effect on the bones. The lead author of the study, Dr. Robert P. Heaney, surmised that soda drinkers tend to have weaker bones that could lead to hip fracture because they were not drinking calcium-rich liquids like orange juice or milk. They have simply replaced them with soda. So, that's why soda causes hip fracture, not directly, but through other circumstances. This is a really good news for soda lovers. When it comes to bones, your favorite drink is not as harmful as a lot of people thought. But of course, you would still need to consider the fact that carbonated drinks, due to their high sugar content, can give you other health issues. Moderation is still the key, plus make sure you also drink healthy beverages. And water should always be your main source of fluid. We hope you have found this latest episode of Aha, So That's Why, quite informative. Please let us know what you think in the comments section below. Don't forget to like this video and to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.